Hey guys, what's going on? Sub and Shun and both here again for another fighting game extravaganza bullshit, and he's singing. Are you still singing the freaking Godzilla shit?
Yeah.
Yeah, Shun recently saw Godzilla, so he's super hyped into it and everything.
The hype is still oozing out of my veins.
Alright. So.
It's actually quite unhealthy.
Who am I? Mains first?
Oh, dicks, you're right.
Let's go random for the first two matches.
Fuck yeah!
You did put the match limit up, right?
Yeah, it's infinite. It's infinite, dog. It's infinite.
Okay, random.
That ish is infinite.
So, if you don't know anything about Dead or Alive, it's a fighting game, all right. But it's a little more in-depth, in my opinion, than most other fighting games.
It's also 3D.
Yeah, it's a 3D fighting game. But it's super more in-depth than a lot of other fighting games I played because of just the... how some
and
of the
And everything
combos
has physics and is jiggly, including the clothes.
Yeah, basically. This game's a lot more harder. I mean, I don't necessarily know compared to Soul Calibur because I'm not a big fan of Soul Calibur. Specifically just because of ring outs. I hate that series a lot more because of that. Wait, yes, I understand. Like, you know, there's certain maps that don't have ring outs.
Oh, shit.
But you know, like a singular map have not like them having a ring out in general just kind of throws me off. Like, there's like no, I don't want to do that. I don't want to lose a fight just because someone fucking hit me too close to a corner. I'd rather be corner comboed, honestly. God damn it. Another thing that's different about this than most other games is that
counters are really hard.
There's a counter function. Yes, like a lot of games have counter functions. But the counters in this is like, you have to fucking input a correct motion in order to do a counter.
Yeah, there are
like
motions
that.
For counters.
So, like, to do certain counters, like, for mid-counter, there's two different types of mid-counters. There's a mid-kick and there's a mid-punch. The high counters
and you have to know what one is going to happen.
Yeah, high counters and low counters work for whatever that they
are. I
don't
even know how to do high or low counters, honestly.
Well, high counter is back and diagonal up. Basically, diagonal up
and don't even get us started on how weird throws are.
Yeah,
throws are
a little bit harder too, depending on what character you're playing as.
Throws are just confusing.
Because
like, you do mid counters in the middle of an attack, and that's how it works. Like when he's punching me, I'm gonna counter him. When I'm punching him, he's gonna counter me. So you have to do mix ups the whole time.
Yeah.
And they have to be high low mix ups. Too. It's really
weird. This game require like most fighting games require a lot of mix-ups because people can just, you know, guard low most of the time, so you always get to get those high hits in or those mid hits. But then you have a game like this where it kind of doesn't matter because you can kind of counter everything at any point in during a fighting sequence. But this game's super in depth. The only issue with us playing it is that we're not very good at it.
We're both really bad.
We haven't. Well, Shun's the only one here who's actually played arcade mode. I've actually been saving arcade mode for future playthroughs because I eventually.
That's so cool.
Because I'll eventually start doing that once I'm probably done with, or at least further along in Blaze Blue, and once I'm done with the other series I currently have.
Oh yeah, and some counters just don't do damage.
Yeah, some counters just
they do shit like that.
Yeah, some counters just don't do shit. So the thing with the grabs, like, we were talking about grabs, but we never actually went into it. Grabs are a little different. Most grabs that you would know will hit anyone no matter what. If they're blocking, the only time they won't get hit is if they're just crouching.
So I guess we could show that off, because we have infinite time.
But at this, alright, so, like, all
oh,
right,
wait,
let's say Shuda is crouching.
No, she can't crouch.
Yeah, you can. You can totally crouch.
No. No, she can't.
She can't. Look, I'm crouching right now. Press back, and then hold down.
Okay,
so Shun is crouching. So I'm gonna do a standing grab. Now I can't grab him worth shit, even when he's not blocking and blocking. The thing about this is,
I can't grab him either.
Yeah, he can't grab me either. Now let's
give
say
your
now Shun stand up for a second. Now Shun is standing up. So this time I'm gonna do a low grab. Now as you can see, I'm not grabbing him. In order to do low grabs and high grabs and all that stuff, they have to be standing for a standing grab and crouching for a crouch grab. So now I'm gonna do a crouching grab instead. And now I actually hit him. And when he does this, now
and Tekken grabs is weird.
Tekken grabs is extremely odd. So I should have just did a standing grab. So like this game is like the functioning is.
And there's back and forward grabs.
Yeah,
that's a standing grab.
Yeah, like there's back like there's a standing. Then
that's
there's
a standing grab.
Yeah, but then we have the... All right, so this is a forward grab. And then let's see what... Let's see. Stand up real quick. This is a standard grab. Just standing. And then get back up real quick.
And they do different damage.
And this is the back grab. There's three different types of grabs for that. And then there's the combo grab. Like, the quarter circle, the half circle, from down to
and
up.
And the back
from,
grab.
Yeah, there's many different things you can do with grabs, counters, and also moves. This game has, you know, your punch, your kick, your block, which is a button. Your grab.
Your triple button.
And then you have your three button hit, your two button hit. It's kind of fucking insane. It's really insane, honestly. And it's
can I just jump over you?
Super in
and
depth.
You can do shit like this.
Yeah, you can do this, and you can also do a side hit and whatnot, like that. It's okay. Someone's getting
and you can taunt.
Yeah, you can taunt too. Which one? That's a left trigger.
Farewell. Very good. I only have two. Well, very
good. Come on. I think that was the exact same one. Farewell. Yeah, I have two as well. So yeah, there's a lot to this game, actually. It's kind of awesome. But at the same time, really fucking... It's like, not something I would recommend for beginners at all.
It's not even annoying to play, it's just like...
Super hard to master.
There's just a lot going on.
Yeah. Especially because, like, there's since... I mean, like, if we were to get each other to a combo, the only way out of it, honestly, is for the combo to end, or for the person to fuck up, or for the person who's getting hit to combo break, to just guard break it. Like, in most fighting games, however, like, you know, like, some games, like Mortal Kombat and Injustice, there's a breaker.
You have breakers.
In Killer Instinct, you have combo breakers, which you just have to perform a double tap of the medium. Like, let's say it's a medium hit he's doing to me, and you just do a medium punch and medium kick, and you combo break it. Then you have games like Marvel vs. Capcom.
We also put a disclaimer that we know nothing about this game.
Yeah. Then you have like games like Marvel vs. Capcom and stuff.
We think we know.
Yeah, this is stuff we think we know.
From
we are
playing
not...
it.
I should have played this game more than I have, which is surprising because I normally play more fighters than he does in both terms of...
But like, I really like this game.
Yeah, it's not a bad game at all. It's just super hard to learn at some points, especially because the tutorial mode like has like 48, I think, freaking lessons in total. Like Persona had like what? Like
oh yeah, and you can move the camera around when
win. Yeah, like when you lose, you can freaking pan around.
I have some pretty sick hair, not gonna lie.
Yeah, pretty sick hair. So, like, that was a quick rundown of the game. Like, we haven't done that with any of the other ones, really. But this one's really unique in that.
Because we understand the other ones.
Yeah, we understand the other
ones.
This game. This one is new to us. I actually picked this game up. I picked up the original Dead or Alive 5, and we got Ultimate. Because I kept bugging Shota to buy it, because it was on sale.
And I bought it.
Yeah,
and
he totally didn't look back.
I totally didn't look back. But then again, the only fighting game I bought that I've looked back so far has been Mortal Kombat.
I feel like you probably would have enjoyed it more if
oh, yeah.
I had not
I like
played
this girl.
Oh, I'm playing the Luchador. With a fucking sequined dress.
Mariposa. You're playing the Butterfly.
Oh, there you go. This game also has arenas. Like you know, little stage hazards and whatnot.
God, I don't remember how to play this girl.
But okay. There is nothing. There's no stage hazard that's super bad, though. I mean, you're just getting bonus damage, if anything. Nothing that actually.
Like,
is,
I
like,
think
gameplay.
I can punch you out this wall.
Oh, gotcha.
Shit.
Oh, look at that fucking dance! Oh my god! Fucking dancey dance! Okay, no, like, yo, you can't handle this shit.
Dude, I can't handle that. You're too spinny.
Oh my god. What the
You're
fuck?
Too spinny, dog!
Oh.
Oh, I did a Superman punch.
No, you didn't. Oh, your Superman punch is,
That was totally a Superman punch.
No, your Superman punch is diagonal forward punch, I believe. Yeah, there it is. That's a Superman punch.
That.
Also, I was fucking trapped in the corner. I was not even trying to block.
Oh yeah, you can corner people like crazy in this game.
Yeah, especially if they can't catch the big
Maybe that's because we're bad.
Yeah, that may be true as well, but we're super not going to try the multiplayer. No. How do I break out of this?
Shit!
Kick.
That pot hit me in the head. It says diagonal forward punch?
Diagonal forward punch is for Superman punch.
Like diagonal then forward?
No. As like you're holding up and yeah,
oh, okay.
Up and forward.
Oh.
I said diagonal up. Shit.
Oh, I just heard diagonal forward punch.
So of course me and Shota have our mains, but we're not gonna play them until the last fight.
Last couple fights, because our mains are fun.
Yeah, our mains are fun because we actually do shit. Mainly because when we're fighting with our mains, like, we're actually somewhat,
competent.
Competent, yeah, I guess that's the word. So if you watch any of our other fighting games, you may have noticed that actually Shota won a round. Like, completely won a match. Because you completely won a match before. It's just then. I didn't say anything about it before because I didn't realize it. Also, what?
I fucked that up.
Another thing is, it's really hard to read if an attack is high or low. Like that. That's a low hit, but I wasn't reading it right. Okay. And then I have people coming online because I don't go busy for fighting games at all. Well, multiplayer.
Yeah, because you have to accept me.
Yeah, because we got to...
Accept me into your life. God damn it.
So, as I said for like any of the other fighting games, any expert would probably tell us that we're doing something wrong, but we don't really care because we're still learning. And we intend to get at least fairly decent at the games that we play.
Shit.
God damn it.
I don't like how many mix-up your girl has. It's annoying. Like, she's mixing up so much.
Shit. That's another thing. Was that a medium? Did you block that with a medium? Was that a high?
That was a medium.
How was that a fucking medium? Like that's what I'm talking about. Like, that would clearly look like a high hit. Yeah, he blocked it with a medium.
And I think some things just can't be countered.
There we go.
Ooh, that does a lot.
Fuck.
Dick.
Gotcha.
And I counter a lot in this game.
Yeah,
like, it's the main thing I do.
I don't really know how to
counter. One of my characters is good at
hold. I'm starting to learn counters. Like, this is honestly the most I've countered in period since we've been playing.
Yeah, this is probably the most he's countered out of all the matches. Like, he's done it like 4 times,
what
I think.
What the fuck?
God, that looks like it hurts. Shit! Dude, that does a fucking quarter of my health.
Well, yeah, because it's a counter, dude. It's a... Oh, shit. Oh shit! No! I fucking hit too early! No, I was trying to back off. I didn't mean to press B.
I pressed B too. I'm look around. Can I see you anywhere?
Can we zoom in at all? Like, I was
kidding. Yeah. Okay. Oh, you can turn the. You can turn it sideways.
I just saw it. Because I wanted to zoom in on the bandage on your head. On your eyebrow.
You can take pictures when you're.
Really?
In a windscreen.
I didn't know that.
You can make it really creepy.
I'm guessing that's an achievement.
I haven't tried it just because I was like, this is weird.
This is weird. The otaku glasses then come on.
Yeah, they're like sliding up my neck and onto my face. Oh, you look like a douchebag.
You look like a douchebag.
I'm Tina's dad.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is Tina's dad.
You're fucking scary.
He has no moves.
Is he a grab character?
No, he's not. He just doesn't have a lot of moves.
That stance he has looks totally grab character. Fuck!
That's because he used to be a professional wrestler. I didn't do that. I'm not gonna lie, I didn't
Are you
do
kidding
what
me?
He did. Oh yeah, we both like to kick each other when we're down.
Yeah, it's kind of a thing. Shit.
And something cool about this game is, we've only played female characters so far in the random, but the roster in this game, all the characters are pretty well balanced, and they all look pretty cool.
Ryu's still S tier, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure Ryu's S tier.
He probably is. He has too much bullshit going on.
He's too fast, dude. He's too fast. He's got a lot of movesets.
Too fast, too furious.
Kind of like how, well, actually, should we do a Marvel vs. Capcom one?
Yeah, why not?
Alright.
It'll just be you showing off how much I suck.
Yeah, and also show... Well, I mean, I haven't played that in a while. I've been meaning to actually bring that series back for, like, the longest time because people have been commenting on the videos. Oh my god, do you want to fucking keep juggling me? Okay, okay. Fucking shit.
Shit, that wasn't it.
Oh no, oh no. Gotcha!
Around I wanted to grab you, but grabs are weird.
I was honestly going to try to grab you as well, but I was super afraid.
Showtime! Showtime!
Shit!
Yeah, fuck you.
I mean, just the thing with guarding is just like with any game, it gets super... You just gotta learn the characters better to actually figure out when to guard.
Yeah, like, I can guard against Ryu a lot better than I can any of the other characters he's playing.
But that's because Ryu is my main, and a lot of Ryu's attacks are mid-punches, honestly.
Which is awesome.
But there are more mix-up, but I don't really know most of the mix-up still.
Why the fuck is there a Rap Alicia in here? That doesn't make sense.
I think that for the fight before main, we should play our second, our alt characters.
Okay. That would be Kokoro, I think. Ah, shit.
So this is like honestly this and Persona are the two games, or this Persona and BlazBlue are the games that me and Shin are mostly evenly matched in.
Yeah, all the other ones, there's no. I'm a little bit better in this. In the beginning, when he gets going, he's better just because I'm not good at fighting games. Like, I don't know how to play them.
Oh, fuck! Oh, that's it. I'm done. Oh, I'm totally done. Like, after he did that spin, I was like, nope, yeah, that's it. Like, oh, what the fuck was that?
I just kicked
what
your
reach
foot.
Was that? Oh, no, that was a punch, dude. Like, I...